questions which are asked by our students as doubts. So I'm going to clear these doubts in this video. So let us see this first question. This question is specifically asked by many students, not just one or two students. Many students don't find proper explanation or proper answer for this kind of questions anywhere else. So that will be provided now. So the question is, he's asking you to find out what is the natural time period of oscillations of the machine or a synchronous machine. Basically, you know, in a synchronous machine, there is a phenomenon called as hunting. So what is hunting? Whenever the load on the system suddenly changes, then it will start oscillating. The rotor starts oscillating. So that is only called as hunting, and you have to find out the value of this hunting or the frequency of that oscillation under the most worst condition, that is the short circuit condition. So basically, we are interested, whenever he asks you to find the natural time period of oscillation, means when the three-phase fault occurs on the terminal of the generator, what is the oscillation of the rotor at that time to regain stability. That is only called as this time period of oscillation. Though, so there is a big derivation for that, but there is a formula for that one. Okay, instead of going through the derivation, I just remember you to remember the formula for that one. So time period of oscillation. Okay, that time period will be equal to 546.6 synchronous speed multiplied by moment of inertia J divided by excitation EMF IF into short circuit current ISC into the supply frequency. Okay, please keep this formula in a box, because you are never going to find this formula in any textbook again. Okay, so and it is very much important for you to remember this formula also. Why? Because this is you know, one of the most twisted or confused question asked in this competitive exams basically. So let us find out the values whatever required. So in the question itself, he has given the value of J as how much? 10 power 7 kg meter square. And he has given you, what else he has given you? He has given you the per unit reactance of the system, isn't it? Or he has given you, simply I can say, Z per unit has been given. How much? 0.5 per unit, it seems. So if Z per unit is 0.5 per unit, what will be the short circuit current for a three-phase short circuit? 1 by Z per unit, isn't it? So that will be equal to how much per unit? 2 per unit. So short circuit current will be 2 per unit. So I have to find out the actual value of short per actual short circuit current. So I have to multiply the per unit short circuit current into the base value of the current. So how do I find the base value of the current? So I base will be equal to MVA rating into 10 power 3 divided by under root into KV rating of the machine, isn't it? So MVA rating is how much? 100 divided by root 3 into 33. So that is the I base value. And what will be the short circuit current? Short circuit current is 2 times the I base, isn't it? Per unit is 2. So after solving this, upon solving this, we will get 3499.09 amperes. Okay, as a short circuit current. Okay, next you have to find out EF. EF is nothing but the excitation EMF. So EF is nothing but whatever the line voltage is given in the question by root 3. That means you have just to find the phase voltage of that given voltage. So this is how many volts? 33,000 volts, isn't it? By root 3, that gives you how much? 19,052.55 volts. So that is the excitation EMF EF. So you got all the required values, and find out the NS. NS is equal to 120 into F by P. So 120 into F is 50, and number of poles are 2 poles. And upon solving this, you get how much? 3000 RPM, isn't it? 3000 RPM. So put in the formula. The formula says 546.6 NS. What is NS? 3000 multiplied by under root. J is 10 power 7 and EF is 19,052.5 into short circuit current is 3499 into frequency of supply is 50. And after solving this, you will get 24.9 seconds as the answer, which is option D. So if he is asking you to find the natural frequency of oscillation, that will be equal to 1 by time period of the oscillation. That's it. Whatever you got, 24.9, take it 1 by, then you will get the frequency of oscillation in hertz. That's it, the solution for this question. Okay, next question, you see, a voltmeter is giving, this is a part of our mock test in machines, this question. This is question number 7 of our mock test. Voltmeter gives 120 oscillations per minute when connected to the rotor of an induction motor. Stator frequency is 50 hertz, slip of the motor. So you are connecting a voltmeter to the rotor and it is oscillating, means the rotor, whatever the rotor voltage is AC. And if there is AC voltage, it will have frequency. What frequency means? Number of cycles per second. Okay. Number of cycles per second means I can write number of oscillations per second, isn't it? Okay, number of oscillations per second. So if I am saying frequency is 50 hertz, means how many oscillations per second? 50 oscillations in 1 second. Now he says that in a voltmeter, when you are connecting to the rotor, it is giving how many oscillations per minute? 120 oscillations per minute. Frequency means what? Oscillations per second. So 120 in 1 minute means how many for 1 second? 120 by 60. So that will give you how much? 2 hertz, isn't it? So the frequency of the rotor is 2 hertz. And you know that rotor frequency is equal to slip times the stator frequency. You want to find the slip. Slip is equal to rotor frequency by stator frequency, and is asking the answer in percentage. So multiply with 100. 2 by stator frequency is 50 into 100, 50 once and twice, 4% is the stator frequency, the slip, percentage slip of the motor. Option C is the answer. Next question. Next question is, one of the speeds of 2-speed squirrel cage induction motor is 600 rpm. The lower speed, the other speed will be, is asking. So basically this concept arises from a consequent pole changing method of speed control. In pole changing method, you can get obtains of only two speeds, okay, one low speed and one high speed. Why? Because in pole changing method, what we will do is we will adjust the number of pole, because the synchronous speed in this induction machine is proportional to 120 into F by P. That means it depends on the poles. So if you vary the number of poles, you can vary the synchronous speed. So that is the idea. So in case of pole changing method, what we can do is we can change the poles in the ratio of 1:2 only. Okay. So if you can, that means you can wind the winding for 2 number of poles, that is in 1:2 ratio. If poles are wound in 1:2 ratio, then the speed will be in 2:1 ratio. If one speed is 600, the other speed will be automatically twice, that is 1200 rpm. Understood? So option D will be the right answer. So it is wrongly given in our key. I will correct it. Option D is the answer for this question. Next question is, for a given system, LG fault on the line side of the transformer is equivalent to LG fault on the generator side, LL fault on the generator side, 3-phase fault on the generator side, LLG fault on the generator side. Now you see, there is a transformer with delta on primary and star with neutral grounding on the secondary. Secondary side is line side and primary side is the generator side. If one LG fault occurring on the line side or the secondary side, how will the primary side of the transformer will feel this like? Will it feel it like LG fault only or some other fault only, he is asking basically. So before getting into that, let me just simply draw the winding diagram. So three-phase winding diagram. So how it will look like? So the three-phase winding diagram will generally look like this. So you will have this kind of winding, isn't it? On the primary, on the secondary side, you are having star winding. That means all starting ends or finishing ends are jointed together and that will be grounded. So let us say this is the star connection with the neutral grounding, that is on the secondary side. Okay. Now on the primary side also, you will have three phase windings, which are connected in what? In delta. So in delta connection means something like this, isn't it? So these are the three phase primary connections. Okay,
always in a transformer, let us say it is a core type transformer or a shell type transformer. If it is a core type transformer, three phase core type transformer, okay, there will be three legs and two windows like this. The winding looks something like this, okay. That means the winding will be wound on the three legs in this way, okay. So three phase windings will be wound like this. So on one leg there will be primary side of R, and there will be on the others on the same leg only the secondary side of the R also will be wounded, okay. That means like this. So let us say that is the primary side or one high voltage side, and another one is the low voltage side. Similarly, let us take in the this limb, okay, Y phase will be there, high HV side, and LV side Y phase will be there. Similarly, on the other side, HV side winding will be there of further phase, and LV side also will be there on the same leg only. Why do we do this kind of winding? This kind of winding is called as interlinked winding. That will actually reduce the leakage reactance. If reduce the leakage reactance, the power factor of the machine will improve. So these are the other some factors. Okay, anyhow. So always what I meant to say is, always this winding and this winding, primary side winding and secondary side winding of a one phase will be on the same core. Okay, will be on the same core. This will be on the same core. These two windings will be on the same core. Now he says that on the secondary side or on the star with the neutral grounding side, on one phase, LG fault takes place. Let us say on this phase, LG fault has taken place. LG fault means what? Phase fallen to the ground, connected to the ground. So if phase is connected to the ground, the path will be completed by this neutral point. Hence, fault current will be flowing, and that value of fault current will be equal to neutral current, which is equal to 3 times of Ia naught. These things we have already studied in fault analysis. Okay. Now, how will be the value of fault current, low or high? Very, very high, isn't it? Very, very high. So when a normal transformer is operating, okay, when you give a voltage V supply to the input or primary side, it will generate a working value of flux phi. This will induce a current E2 on the secondary side, and this E2 current will produce a flux phi2. Okay, this phi2 flux, okay, again induces, or it circulates, okay, E2 current actually produces a current I2, and this I2 current produces a flux phi2, and this flux phi2 will be trying to oppose this flux, isn't it? It will try to oppose the flux, and this is how the transformation action happens. So when the flux is given, there are so this flux phi2 will be producing an opposition on the primary side flux, isn't it, from the flux produced by the primary side. So under normal conditions, under normal operating conditions, for power transfer condition, we said that primary side ampere turns will be equal to secondary side ampere turns, isn't it? So primary side ampere turns will be equal to secondary side ampere. So when a fault occurs on the secondary side like this, this fault current, okay, this fault current will induce a very heavy voltages, because both are on the same side, okay. So primary side flux will be in this way, and secondary side flux will be in this way. Both will be opposing to each other, that thing we know, okay. So when secondary side fault occurs, the value of flux produced by the secondary will be much higher, and this much higher flux will try to neutralize all the voltage which is produced over here. That means whatever the supply voltage is applied here, it will try to neutralize the all the voltage by inducing a an EMF on this phase. So when the net voltage across this phase becomes zero, when net voltage across any element is equal to zero, means what? That is equal to a short circuit. Now if this phase is short circuit, means this another line is directly connected to the another line, isn't it? So this is equivalent to which fault? LL fault. So due to the fault in one phase, this phase current will be too high, that it will induce an opposite voltage on the next phase or on the primary side, which will neutralize all the voltage, all the opposition, everything is present over here, and make net voltage across that phase equal to zero. That will automatically result into a LL fault on the generator side. So option B is the right answer for this question. Thank you for watching.